Hello guys, well, welcome back. I hope you're all keeping well and safe, obviously during the period of this lockdown. I mean, COVID-19 is affecting everyone. So, like I said, I hope you're all being safe and sticking to the isolation and the lockdown rules. So, it's been a long time since I last posted a video. Like everyone who's been stuck in the house, I've obviously been trolling the internet, been going on eBay and Amazon, etc., looking at bits of kit that I can buy to use when eventually we can get out into the hills legally. Many hours for the frustration of the wife. I've been on the internet and I decided that I wanted to buy myself a new tent. Now, I've been on YouTube, I've watched a few videos with reference to this tent that I actually purchased from Amazon. And those people that have watched my videos before know that, you know, the two setups that I use at the moment is the DD tarp 3x3 and my Hilleberg, which, you know, both systems are fantastic. As you know, I do my hill walking, wild camping with Fudgy, my Springer. So I like to have, I don't want to carry too much kit, but I like to have enough room in my tents so that myself and Fudge can comfortably fit in them. So I mean, the DD tarp is fantastic. There's loads of room in there. However, you know, when you set it up, there is an open area, and especially when I'm asleep at night, even though she won't run away, there is that chance that she could just wander out or see a rabbit, etc., and go while I'm asleep. And the Hilleberg, like I said, I haven't got a problem with that. That's fantastic. But, you know, we're all wild campers. We all like to have a new piece of kit. So I decided to buy myself a new tent off Amazon. And what I went for was this, the Lux Sil Hex Peak Fictor 4 Alpha. I've got it here. It arrived about 2-3 days ago. Now, it's a hexagon tent or a TP tent. It doesn't come with any poles. You use it in conjunction with a walking pole, which, you know, takes the poles away, which is not a problem. And I've, like I said, I've watched it on YouTube a few times. I've seen some guys operating with it, and I thought, yeah, I'll actually buy that tent. That's good. It has a fantastic festival outside. It has an inner tent, which you can do things with, etc. So, yeah, and you know, I've seen it being used in bad conditions, and it looks like it can stand up to what I need a tent to do for me. So, I have it here. I've opened it just to check that the contents were in there. It hasn't been set up yet, which I'm going to do later on. I'm going to go out into the woods somewhere and set it up. This is not a review of the tent, guys. This is just me buying a new tent and setting it up for the first time and bringing you along as well. As it says in the title as well, okay, I will be giving a tent giveaway. I won't be giving this tent away, but I will be giving another tent away. So stay tuned for that, and I will give you the terms and conditions, as they say, on how you can win that tent. I mean, the tent's £130. It's brand new, hasn't been used, so I think that's quite a good deal. So I'll be giving that away at the end. So stay tuned. Other than that, I think I'll grab my kit together. It's a beautiful day outside. So I'm going to get out, get Fudge, and take the tent and put it up. And if you want to, come along and we'll get this sorted. So thanks for sticking this far in the video. Okay, I need to get back to doing this again, get used to doing videos and talking to the camera. So, you know, if you've got any comments about this tent, then by all means, please put the comments below. I will leave a link in the description for Lux and where you can find this tent. And also I'll leave the statistics, the weight, the size, etc., what it's made of in a description below. So yeah, I think that's it now. Less talking, let's get out, let's get into the sunshine, and let's get this tent sorted. So, thanks very much.
So here we are, guys. I've managed to come out to my local woods. I'm actually in the corner of a farmer's field, just to get out of the way. I have the tent here. So what I'm gonna do, unpack it, put it up in slow time behind me, and see how it goes. So stay tuned.
So there you go, guys, that is it roughly set up. I haven't set it up to its best specifications. The guys could be a little bit tighter, etc., but it gives you a general idea of what it it's like. As you can see, it's a hexagonal shape with obviously the use of a walking pole just inside there, has an inner and obviously its outer. You are provided, I'll just go over here, with a obviously tent bag, which I'll probably get rid of and just stick it in a stuff sack because it'll be a lot easier. A peg bag which can hold the pegs, and you get six pegs. Okay, you get six pegs. These are the pegs that come with it. So they're not too bad. But because I knew I had to get some more, I went on eBay and bought some like this for £4 for 10 or something like that. And can you tell the difference? The only difference is that the ones I got off eBay, Amazon, have a measuring side to it, so there's not much difference there. So I bought myself some more sticks, pegs, and it also comes with a a strap, which once you roll it up, you can obviously keep it nice and tidy. The reason I got more pegs is, yes, it has six tie down points on each corner, but then in the middle it has extra tie down points, lock tie down points, which are these, and you know, there's no guy ropes or any pegs. So what I've ordered off of eBay again, Amazon again, is some elastic. So I will put that on there, and then I'll be able to pin that down and make it a little bit more taut in foul weather. And you have one of them on each side, and you also have extra guy rope loops. Now these are guy ropes that I had in my shed, and I've just put them on there for now, but I've also again ordered some more guy rope. I've ordered it yellow to keep it in line with the guy ropes on the actual tent, so that will be changed out, and again it will just give it a lot more stability. One thing that you do get with the tent is a seam sealer. Now from the YouTube videos that I've watched, everyone says that they've had no problems with damp water getting in, but because they provided the seam sealer, what I did is I went ahead and I did the main seams, as you can see, this one, one across, one on top there, and all the way around the back, which I would call the crown, and then the peak on the top here, I then just gave it a liberal amount of seam sealer, because obviously that's going to have a lot of water on there because of the walking pole handle inside. Some features: it has a loop on the top, so if you are putting it up in let's say a wood, then you could probably put a guy line through there from tree to tree and put it on that instead of using an inner pole. To prevent condensation, you have inside here, just get inside, a small ridge, a small little hook which will stick out, and then as you can see, when the door's shut, you have ventilation there. Okay, the inner tent. The only thing I don't like about the inner tent, it's big enough for me and Fudge. The only thing I don't like about it is the sip. It's just a half sip, so open that up. You can tie it back, but as you can see, it only goes to there and not all the way along, which isn't, you know, isn't that bad, but it would be better if you could get it all the way there and fold it all the way back. Plenty of room. There's plenty of room in there for me and Fudge. I'm 6 foot and my feet don't even touch the end, and I've tried it, and Fudge can sit in that corner there, and it's fantastic. And even if it's good weather, warm weather, the festival is fantastic. Look at that. Look how much room you've got in there. So, get over there. So, you could put your kit in there, all in there, you know, your bergen, your rucksack, whatever you're carrying, and then you've got all this area to administrate yourself. If you drop the door, I've got it folded back at the moment. If you drop the door, and it comes out with your other walking pole, you could quite easily, you have a hook there, put that out there and just give you that little bit extra room, a little bit of protection from the wind or the rain if it's raining, etc. And another thing what you can do is, because it's got an inner tent, if you go and look inside here where it's connected by a small hook here, so you could quite easily lower this down. Okay, imagine it's inclement weather, unhook that hook there, drop it down, and look at that. You can then just sit on the inside. Imagine you would have your sleeping bag, your sleeping mat inside there, and then you would sit on top, and if you're out with mates or friends, you know, and the weather's unpleasant, then there's plenty of room for two people in there, maybe even three, just for a brew, etc. Or again, if you're administrating yourself, there's a lot more space in there for you to administrate yourself. Also remembering that you don't really want to get that inner wet. But yeah, it's not a bad little setup, and I'm looking forward to using it. What else can I tell you about it? Right, the outer, it's made of 40D nylon ripstop, the fabric. One side of it is obviously protected, siliconized. So obviously, eventually, you'll probably will have to re-waterproof it. But like I said, which comes with the pack, you do get a silicone seal and a couple of little brushes to paint the seams. But that's like with any tent, really. The inner, that's made of a high density nylon. The actual bug sheet looks quite good and looks midge proof. It has a a waterproof bottom, which is fantastic. And you can actually, like I said, I haven't said before, but you can buy a ground sheet, a footprint. So if you wanted to, you could have a footprint inside as well, but I'd be quite happy like that, and then maybe put a seat, a mat that I could sit the backside on while I'm in there, which isn't too much of a bother. So yeah, and you can also, Lux do, I think it's for £30, a specialised inner pole, which comes in two pieces, I think, and you can put it in instead of using your walking stick. But I've got walking sticks, so I might as well use them. I think it's to the height of about 120 centimetres that it goes to. But as you can see all the way around, you do have a little bit of a gap which aids in ventilation, which is fantastic. So if you've got a breeze, you know, hopefully that will stop any condensation building up inside. But like I said, the reason I went for this tent is because we all like something different. I think it looks a bomb-proof little tent. I have seen them on other YouTube channels and I haven't really heard anything bad about them. One thing that someone did say on one of them is, if you're going to use it and maybe you're setting it up on maybe soft ground, etc., obviously you have got your pole. They said, and this is totally down to you whether you want to do it or not, get a tennis ball, cut the tennis ball in half, keep that, and half the tennis ball goes on top there to stop the obviously rubbing of your walking pole, and the other half goes on the bottom of the walking pole, and it just gives you a little bit more purchase on the ground if the ground is a bit wet. But I think, well, I know that, you know, this is going to be way big enough for me and Fudge, and you know, the added advantage of it is it comes with no poles. The weight of it, the outer fly is 660 grams plus or minus a few, you know, it's not going to be fantastic. If it's wet, it's going to be a lot more. The inner again is 600 grams. So, you know, weight wise, it's fantastic. And I really am looking forward to getting out there and using this once we get off of this bloody lockdown. There you go, there you can see, Alux. There will be a link in the description for this tent, and I will put a link in the description for any other pieces that come with it. But other than that, fantastic bit of tent. You know, come, Fudge, come here. Yeah, in here. Up, up, Fudge, up, stay there, down. Good girl, and there you go. You know, inclement weather, Fudgy's in there. She, you know, there's plenty of room for her, and there's plenty of room for me, and you know, we can make a brew. Make a brew, have some scoff, sort your stuff out whilst it's raining outside, as it always does when we go out on the ground. So yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to using this tent. Guys, if you've got one, or you know, you're thinking of getting one, please leave a, you know, a comment down below. If you've had any experience with one, any faults that may have come about with one of them, then please let me know, because you know, I'm interested. I really am interested. And like I said, I've added these guy ropes on. I have got some coming, yellow ones, and I've got some of these locks coming as well, so they'll be going on. And I've also got, like I said, the elastic, so an elastic loop will be going on there. So just to put another peg in there to give it a bit of stability when you're in the hills, because obviously, you know, when the wind's blowing, it is quite high, but as long as you've got it fastened down. And if I do go out in inclement weather, or I know it's going to be windy, then I will take my D-pegs with me as well, just to make sure everything's okay. But yeah, that's the tent. Like I said, it's not a review. It's just my opinions. It's just what I've seen. A new bit of kit. Everyone likes a new bit of kit. Been on Amazon doing overtime, buying stuff. So let me know what you think about that, guys. I think it's time for a brew.
So there you go, guys. That is the Lux Sil Hex Peak tent. I'm really, really looking forward to getting out into the hills once we're allowed to use that and put it through its paces. It looks a cracking tent, looks just what I need. So let's hope we get out there very soon. Before you comment, yes, home attempt at a haircut had to come off. I just had hair and I was sweating and it was horrible. So yeah, a lockdown haircut. I think this is going to be a fantastic bit of kit. Like I said before, if you've had an experience with one of these tents, then please put some comments down below. I'd love to hear from you. But I'm excited to use it and it will be going on my next wild camp. So then, like I said at the start of the video, I want to do a tent giveaway. Now, the reason I'm doing a tent giveaway is prior to buying this tent, obviously I was discussing it with the boss, the wife, and I just mentioned that I was looking at that tent and I felt like I was going to buy one. So she thought she would surprise me and she went out and bought a tent. The wrong one. And you know what we're like with our tents, it's got to be the perfect one. And I have been given permission to give this tent away. Okay, now this tent is worth £130. Okay, it is the Lanshan Outdoor Ultralight 1-2 person tent. Okay, it's like I said, worth £130, and it is very lightweight at 1.1 kilograms. Here it is. Okay, it's a tent that has no poles, you use your walking poles. So if you're up for this and you want to try and win this, or you know, be in the competition, there's a few ground rules. First of all, you have to be a subscriber, so please go ahead and subscribe, like the video, and then in the comments leave "I'm in." Okay, just leave in the comments "I'm in," and then what I'll do, it's Saturday today, next Saturday I will take all the names that have put "I am in," I will put them in a randomizer on the computer and the computer will pick out one person who will be lucky enough to win this tent. All right, it's the first time I've ever done this, so hopefully it will all go well. I'll make it as fair as possible. So if you want to win this, you need to be in it, you need to leave a comment, and you need to be a subscriber. Other than that, guys, I look forward to doing that next week, and I look forward to getting out and using that tent when I can with Fudgy. I hope you liked the video. If you have, please like, subscribe, share the video, and leave any comments. Like I said, if you've had experience with one of them tents, then please leave a comment below. I will be leaving off the information in the description about the tent, where you can buy it, what equipment that you can also get with it. So thank you very much for staying with me this long, and for now that's it. So goodbye.